here with you folks, not you personally, but groups like you, talking about and representing the fine work that's been done by a great group of individuals back in Detroit to engineer this car that you see here in front of us today. This car started shipping earlier this week, and it's on its way to dealers. And to me, that is the best time to be here with you guys to talk about all of the great things about this car. When we started engineering this car, we had a sort of a saying internally, which was Gen 1 or better, which means we want to start with what we knew. We now had customers who could give us feedback, and we wanted to always make sure that we were exceeding where we were before. And now that that car is done, we think about it and we talk about Gen 2, better in every way, because we actually did succeed in making it better in every way. We first, of course, talked to the customers that we have. You heard we've got about 80,000 customers worldwide for this technology, and we went back and talked to them and said, what do you want more of? What do you want us to make better? And of course, the first, second, and third answers were range. We want more electric range, and we've delivered that. We now have 53 miles of electric range, which is a combination of slightly larger battery, more efficient powertrain, and we can talk to you more about the details of that later. We've got better fuel economy, now 42 miles per gallon combined. So after you're done depleting the battery, and we get a chance to do that tomorrow, you get, again, combined 42 miles per gallon, 106 mpge. Quicker. 0 to 60 times faster, now 8.4 seconds, and my favorite, 0 to 30 times, 2.6 seconds, about almost 20% faster, because it really gives you that oomph off the line, that feel, that nice, smooth, electric feel, and you really feel it now. Sporty design, I think, as you can see here, other than the cutaway panels, right? Kevin said it earlier, which is it's all new on the outside, all new on the inside. Tim Gregg is here, and he'd love to talk to you about some of the things that we did on the inside of this car. And a more friendly interior. We did get some feedback that said we'd like it easier to work. We'd like to make it so that I can do two things at once. I don't have to go to the screen for everything, and we've delivered that as well. So again, we can show you some of that, and tomorrow you get a chance to really experience that. I talked a minute ago about the battery, right? How did we get 53 miles of range? We did that by having a larger, more energy dense, excuse me, not larger, roughly the same size. You see back here the T-shaped battery. It's still T-shaped, runs down the center of the car underneath the rear seats. It's only slightly physically larger, but it's got more energy in it. It's got about 20% more by volume as far as energy goes. The capacity now is 18.4 kilowatt hours. How did we do that? Fewer cells. And we've got some cutaways over here where we can show you that we used to have three cells in parallel, and then we strung those 96 of those triplets in a row. Now we just have two cells in parallel, 96 of those twin pairs, and we can therefore get better space utilization, put more energy into that pack. We've also got a different controls architecture inside the pack, which has been simplified, again, creating more space. And we still have our active thermal system in there so that we can maintain the battery at the ideal temperatures so we can still have a guarantee on battery life, just like we did in Gen 1. That's very important. And as you heard, secondary use, right? We want to make sure those batteries are good even when they're done with the life of the car so we can put them into secondary use. And take all that, more energy, same size, more dense, 20 pounds lighter. The whole car is over 200 pounds lighter. The battery is one of those parts that's contributing to that. Moving along, we've got a new range-extending engine, the 1.5-liter small gas engine. Many people ask, why didn't you make it smaller? Why didn't you do this? Why didn't you do that? It's larger because we can get the same energy, excuse me, the same power out of that and run at a lower speed so we can be quieter. And quiet and fun to drive is some more of the feedback that we got from our customers. They said, When you're running on engine, what we want you to do is make it so that it's as quiet and smooth as possible, maintaining as much of that EV feel that you get used to having every day, even when the engine is running. And we can do that with this new engine. It's direct inject, high compression ratio. We've got cooled EGR to help us manage that high compression ratio. And runs on regular fuel. Very important. Gen 1 ran on premium fuel. Customer said, we really would like you to get to regular. The drive unit. this is probably one of the best stories under the hood. Luckily, the engine guys aren't here to hear me say that, right? As you can see here from the cutaway, and we'll be able to give you some demonstrations over here, we've been able to get 12% more efficient. We've still got 149 horsepower for motoring. That's almost the same as it was in Gen 1. We've got a 45 kilowatt generator in there, almost 300 foot-pounds of torque, smaller, lighter by 100 pounds, okay? Why? How did we do that? It now has integral power electronics all built into the case. Everything's in there in one package. You basically bring the large DC cables to it. No more big three-phase cables running around. Much more compact, lighter, more efficient. What does it all mean when it's all said and done, right? Bigger battery, more efficient, lighter. But we get this 40% improvement in EV range, right? And as a Gen 2 owner, you could expect to go, on average, 1,000 miles between fill-ups. And some people will get up to 1,500 miles between fill-ups. Again, if you think about it, 90% of the trips that people will take will now be done purely on battery, burning no gasoline. In Gen 1, that was 80%. As we extend the range, we think that's going to go up to 90%. And you'll displace 25% more gasoline than Gen 1 did originally. I think the number was 34 million gallons, right? If you look at that, on average, we think we're going to displace 25% more over the same period of time, next time around with Gen 2.